Again, right now we have the next round of heavy rain just moving into the Omaha Metro. It's on the left side of your screen there. But I do want to mention in southwest Iowa, there is a severe thunderstorm warning for Adams and Taylor County, specifically just to the east of Villisca near the city of Gravity, south of Corning. There could be some ping pong ball sized hail, 60 mile an hour winds with that as it's moving across southwest Iowa. You can see all that lightning there as well. Getting into Lincoln. Flash flood warnings there, but more heavy rain coming into the city of Lincoln, stretching back toward about the Fairbury area, and everything's pushing east. So there will be more rain in the Omaha Metro in Lincoln for the next hour or two. And just to recap, we have the flash flood warning across Douglas, Saunders, Southern Washington, Western Pottawatomie, and extreme northern Sarpy County. So for all intents and purposes, the Omaha Metro, and then another one around the Lincoln area where there have been several reports of high water this morning. The storms push through. They should be done by 8 or 9 o'clock in Nebraska, maybe by 10 or 11 o'clock in western Iowa. Mostly cloudy. We get a break around the middle of the day with temperatures in the low to mid 60s. North of this front, it is going to be cooler today. I don't think Omaha gets out of the 60s. I think we top out maybe in the mid to upper 60s for highs today. Anytime after 3 o'clock, the next round of thunderstorms moves through, and these are the storms that could produce large hail, damaging winds, even an isolated tornado, and more unneeded heavy rainfall. So as those storms come through late today, temperatures drop back to around 60 degrees. There could be some places down to our south near the Kansas and Missouri borders that hit 80 later today. Scattered strong thunderstorms continue this evening, but after sunset, the chances for severe weather are going to diminish. We could still have some locally heavy rain. Again, in the enhanced risk from the Storm Prediction Center, that's the best chance for severe weather later this afternoon. And anywhere where we have the slight risk, we could still see some hail, damaging winds, and additional heavy rainfall. Significant impact from the flash flooding this morning and the potential for severe weather this afternoon. Just tiny rain shower chances Wednesday and Thursday with temperatures in the low to mid 70s. Back near 80 Friday and Saturday. Saturday we could have some isolated thunderstorms and then another chance for isolated storms early next week.